Good afternoon, classmates. My report for today is about ostomy care. Ostomy means it's a surgical operation and elimination, a process of elimination of body waste. And estoma means opening seen through abdominal wall. And we have three types of ostomy. Ostomy in anatomy, we have colostomy, ileostomy, and urostomy. So colostomy is operation from the colon outside the body, the abdomen.
Then, what is colon?
Large intestine.
Bituka.
Huh? What is colon? Small or large?
Large.
Sure?
Small.
Large.
Huh?
Small.
Ano kinamatay ni Cory Aquino?
Colon cancer.
So which cancer is that? Cancer of the large intestine.
Large.
Say large intestine.
Large intestine.
Okay, so ang colon means large intestine. What is ostomy? Ostomy means to create an opening. Bubutasan ka or you open the part. So colostomy means opening of the what?
Colon.
Ano yung colon?
Large.
Very good. Next, ano naman yung ileostomy? So it's the opening of the
small intestine.
Yes, actually guys, di ba our small intestine is very long. How long are our small intestines? 10 foot. Higher. Higher. 21. Basta mahaba. So mga 21 nga siya, for example. Okay, so that long, the large small intestine rod is divided into three different parts. Meron siyang duodenum, ileum, jejunum. So it depends kung saan ko openin, dun yung pangalan niya. So in this case, ileostomy. So the part of the small intestine that's being opened is the ileum. Okay, ileum plus ostomy equals ileostomy. How about urostomy? Which one is open?
Urinary.
Ano?
Bladder.
Bladder. Sa Tagalog is?
Pantog.
The pantog. Di ba there are people that can no longer urinate? So di ba our bladder is like that, right? And then there's parang imbudo. May imbudo tapos lalabas niya siya. So yung imbudo na yun, either it's clogged, it's blocked, something's wrong with that. So, na-restrict na siya, as in, like, blocked na siya. So, what they do, they open the part of the bladder so that the person can pee through that. Mm-hmm. Okay. There. Next. Stoma. What is a stoma? Stomach. What is a stoma? Can you open that, ano, yung sa kanya, go down. Okay, may kita kayo ng red na parang lips.
Stoma.
Scroll down.
Stoma.
This one, oh.
Okay.
How do you describe the stoma? Describe the stoma. What color is the stoma?
Red.
And then, what is the shape? Circular, pinkish.
Oh,
can we use pink? What's the color of the stoma?
Red, pink.
Red, pink.
So ano ba talaga? Red or pink?
Red, pink, red, moist.
Ano na?
Pink, red, pink, moist. Sorry.
Oh, basta red na pinkish na moist. Okay. So yun yung stoma. So guys, can you imagine your large intestines? Diba ganun yung large intestines? You cut the large intestines, tapos ibuka mo siya, parang
lumalabas.
Okay? So, this, our buccal, is actually our stoma. Okay? Urine. Now, the question is, what color is the stoma again?
Red, pink,
moist. Red, pinkish, okay? So, what is and moist? And then, is it painful?
No. If it is not sick, it's not painful.
Oh, it's not painful pala. Can you touch your cheeks, yung inside of your cheeks? Ganun yung feeling ng stomach. Is it painful?
No.
No, right? If there's pain, then that is already abnormal. Okay, cool, next.
Start na? First, I will just knock the door first before entering the patient's room. Then I will just introduce myself to the patient. Mrs. Jensen, I am Christine, your CNA for today. I will just clean your stomach and can I check your name badge or rest band. First, you need to check the rest band for the patient's name, birth date, and the gender of the patient. And after that, you need to practice high hand hygiene also. And you need to provide privacy for the patient. And ano ba yun? Kalimutan mo na po.
Prepare materials.
Prepare materials.
Save time and energy.
Yeah.
Ano ba ba?
Prepare materials and put
dignity blanket.
Dignity
or privacy blanket.
Yeah. Then the blanket from the patient, you need to put it in the food.
Okay, so syempre, diba, this is involves what? Tae, right? So we don't want that to be spoiled. So we roll it and then we put it there and then we cover the patients with that. What do you call this one?
Dignity blanket.
So
bath
blanket, they said. Tapos, prepare ko yung materials ko. Like, I have this, kunyari lang. This is the paper towel, kunyari, to put in the side table. Top of the side table. Then, I have this spray. Ano ba yung spray na? Deodorant spray. I have, kunyari, the paste for the ostomy pouch. And this one is the... Yeah, in there. Tapos, I have the adhesive remover. And this one is the bedpan. And I have the gloves. And I have the towel. And I have this paper towels also for cleaning. And this one is for the...
Drink.
Ano yung pang
disposable sheet.
You need to
what do you call this in the hospital?
Incontinence.
Inco pad? Or
incontinence pad?
Or blue pad? Or pads?
Changing pads?
Basta pads. Yeah, tapos actually I need also the parang palangga ng maliit.
What do you call this one again?
Or
emesis? Ano bang emesis?
Emesis.
Yung emesis, guys, is yung vomitus. Yung laway, dura, pas, basta yung
Sputum.
Why is it called kidney basin?
Mukha siyang kidney.
Where is your kidneys ulit?
Dito. Sa likod, di ba?
Rio sa likod.
Kaya masakit lagi yung likod.
Okay, good. So you have that.
Yeah, and actually if you need mask, you can do mask because you are living with the pupu. And you can ask also your patient if she needs also mask.
Let's talk reality here. So obviously you'll be handing pupo or tae, diba? Mm-hmm. Is it going to be an awkward procedure or a not normal procedure? How do I say that? Uncomfortable procedure?
Yes.
Mabaho ba yun?
Yes.
Ba to?
Yes.
Definitely, right? So how do you prevent yourself from parang judging the person or him feeling uncomfortable. So, you ask him to wear the mask also. Mag-mask ka. Definitely, dalawang mask pa, right? When is the best time to do this? Before eating, after eating?
Before.
After eating.
Why?
Para tapos niyang kumain before you're doing the
But let's think, if you're gonna do this before eating, do you still have the appetite to eat after ka makakain ng...
Wala na. No, no.
So, usually, mga, let's say, 2 hours after eating, or 2 hours before dinner, mga ganun. So, at least may time ka ba to recover. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Then, if you want to put, actually, if you want to put also a gown. So that you can protect your uniform. Then, we will put this one in the side and it's in the down in the buttocks. Then after that, this one kunyari nandito na siya and this one have buko.
What is that?
This one is the ostomy pouch. This one is one piece. They call it one piece pouch because the two piece pouch is they have the other wafer. Wafer is out yung parang wafer yung ganito. Nakahiwalay siya. Like,
what do you call this one again?
Ostomy pouch.
Ostomy bag. Is it expensive?
It's like 30 dirhams.
30 dirhams yan?
Isang ganyan. In Philippine pesos, magkano yan?
300.
300. How much?
Ang
30.
100
something?
More or less.
So, can you look at this one? Yung quality niya, di ba? Ano lang siya, yung normal na siya na quality, no? Malipis lang siya, pagkatapos ano. So, maybe you can use this for how many days?
Like you can change that one 3 to 7 days.
So, once a week?
Yes.
Once a week yes. or twice a week, right?
It's drainable.
Or twice a week. Now, imagine how much is the cost of that. Let's say 500 yung the cheapest option. Or ano sa Philippines, 500 pesos.
Mm-hmm.
Lagayan lang ng tae, right? Then, how much is that in a month? 2,000. That's if regular ang ano. What if twice ka mag-change in a week? Or thrice in a week? It depends kung gano'ng kadaming tae. So, that is actually expensive na material na gano'ng.
Lubhan.
So, hindi ka na din parang like, you need to change it twice a week.
Yes. Minimum siguro talaga is twice a week, right? That is the ostomy bag and the pouch and that is the one piece kasi hindi magkahiwalay yung wafer at saka yung pouch itself, okay? So, tignan mo nga dyan, Arlene, ano yung ano, paano siya ilalock? Ano ba yan? Tape?
Yes, sir. Close mo siya under, then kung may, wala akong
makong
clip.
Okay. So, what are the different types of that? May mga ano ba yan? May clip ba? Ano pa ba ibang type?
Clip, mayroon din siyang
nandun dito. Ano pa?
Bigay mo kay
Kwan. Bigay mo.
Help her. What else?
Tino.
Si Jeff daw.
Hamaya.
Oh, ito pa nakikita ni Uri dyan. You have the tape. What do you not have?
We have, sir.
Why you don't have?
Nasa WhatsApp.
Sa WhatsApp.
Yo, that's one. Okay. So, there's a clip. There's also a Velcro. Ano ba yung Velcro? You know what's a Velcro?
Di po.
Yung parang ganito.
Strap. Parang strap po.
So, parang strap. Yun yung Velcro na type. Yung gaganan mo. May Velcro, may tape din siguro niya, no? And there's also disposable, meaning wala siyang butas. After using it, that's it, kalas.
Ay, yung plastic lang.
Sir, mag-change na tayo ng ostomy niyo, o ano sa how do you say that na?
Sir, it's fine for you if we will, I'm gonna put you on mask.
Tagalog.
Sir, gusto mo po bang bigyan kita ng face mask because dito, so papalit po tayo nitong pouch.
Okay. Does it sound offensive?
No.
No.
Ha?
Depende. Depende. Depende sa patient, sa deliver mo.
So yung sa kanya, kanina, yung pagka-deliver niya, sa tingin niyo, is it okay? Offensive? Ano ba?
Hindi.
Kasi I wonder, how do you position yourself in that kind of situation? Kasi alam mong mabaho, tapos tae ko naman to, tapos kapag, if you're gonna ask me to wear mask, what are you trying to say?
Nababaho yung tae ko.
Pero how do you say that in a way na you care for him? So, yung sabihin mo ulit.
Oh, sir, gusto mo po bang bigyan kita ng face mask? Kasi po magpapalit po tayo nitong pouch mo.
Yun, okay yun.
Okay, ikaw yun.
Okay po.
Okay.
Yes po.
Kailan si Jeff. So, yun, you have to ask her also, right? Why do you need to open your intestines? Why do you have to have this procedure?
Yung iba po is like yung birth defects. Pagkapanganak, wala na sa lang. They don't have anus. Then they have
so
the cancer.
So that means forever na sila mag-ostomy.
Yes.
Okay. What
then,
else?
Cancer patients.
Like the case of colon cancer,
colon
right?
Cancer.
So they wanted to see that the span of cancer. So what they do, they open the stomach and then they let it heal. Para to heal that, you have to open it and then put the stomach or an ostomy for temporarily or permanently, depends kung gaano kalala yung cancer. Yun. So, how do you feel about this on a psychological or mental level? Kung ikaw ang person, if you are the person with the ostomy, how would you feel?
Una, embarrassed.
Embarrassing, right?
Yes,
what
po.
Else? Ano pang mafe-feel niyo? What if naman you have a husband? So during your sex or you mag-make love kayo, how would that feel?
Stress.
As a woman, how would that feel on your body image?
Stress, nahihira, hindi ka comfortable.
Parang conscious ka na.
Conscious ka.
Masyado.
What if you're a mother of the baby with a birth defect? How would you feel?
Yun lang. Masakit yun.
So, this is not just only procedure. I want you to think about that because this is not just physically. It involves mental. So, paano mo kaya aalaga itong may tao na may tae ka ng, di ba? So, you have to be more empathic of these people pa. Yun ang pwede.
Yes po.
Well, it depends kasi there's a temporary and there's also permanent. Like in her case, yung sabi niya kanina is a birth defect. Most of the time, it's already
permanent. Yeah, forever.
For that person, guys, it's okay because as they grow older, they only learn how to take care of themselves. During the bathing, kung maliligo sila, nililinis na
kaya nila
sa sarili nilang ostomy. But for the people who's just like, for example, cancer ka at the age of 35, and then you're at the peak of your career, or maybe you have a husband, so mas mga ganun. So, parang weird na makipag-sex sa may tayo, right?
Yung lola ko namatay sa ganyan, pumutok.
Yun, mga ganun. Okay? So, that is there. Okay? Next. Continue.
Okay.
Sorry, pinakakita.
Sige lang.
Then, paglilinis, starting for the, we will remove, kunyari may tae na siya, we will remove this one.
By the way, I have a question. Gano'n ba kanamin, how much tae do you need to wait until you change that? Hanggang saan ba yung tae?
What, half or three-fourth
full? Can you raise it and pakita kung saan yung half?
Parang dito yung half or three-fourth full.
Why you don't have to wait until it's full?
Full na siya.
Ha?
Maybe mag-explode?
Baka na siya. Magano na siya.
Hindi mo naman kasi makikita ang bawa. How do they pupo pala? Kasi parang feeling ko na-imagine niya. Kunari,
sir, lalabas lang po siya.
Eh, may kita talagang pupo? Or is it continuous na magpupupo?
Continuous na, lumalabas na lang siya.
Lumalabas
na. Nararamdaman mo pa ba that you want to pee? Or you want to pupo?
No.
Lola ko, sir, hindi niya nararamdaman. As,
Is that like us na we feel the urge na mag-defecate?
Sila po hindi.
So, imagine you're in your large intestines, right? So, nagsa-stomach, napunta sa small intestine, makontinue mo na yung cycle na yan, dire-direction lang siya nalabas. Hindi ka na, So, tuloy-tuloy lang siya. So, pag sabi ni Christine, pag maging 3/4 ka ba, or 1/2?
Half or 3/4, pwede mo siyang, parang i-drain,
Or, kung ano siya, kung reusable, or yung long term, ang gamit mga weeks or days.
Kasi na-open siya dito, like, pati-drain siya dito.
So, kung gasan pa rin
tayo. Okay.
Tapos, kung ano, may double at siya, closure for date, kung makakalikap,
may date pa siya. Okay na? Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how much na tae?
Three.
One half or
three-fourths.
Not full. Because if it's full, our thigh is also composed of acid. Now remember, you have your stomach here, tama?
Mm-hmm.
So if yung stomach mo may exposure into acid, what could happen to your stomach? Could it be, ano, damage?
Yes, sir.
Could it damage siya pag sobrang ng acidic yung environment, right? So you have to really maintain the health ng stomach mo. Kasi pag once your stomach is dead or sick, then they may have another operations again to open another part of the stomach again, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who's doing to be blamed? See?
CNA.
You're not taking good care of your patient, right?
Yes, sir.
So, you have to really make sure na ang tae, hindi as much as possible mag-stick. Though magta-touch talaga siya, but it should not stick na
may tae talaga.
Para healthy pa rin siya. Okay, cool.
So, remove na natin siya. Kasi,
ano,
medyo three days na siyang nakalagay. So, sabi nila, you need to put the bedpan to your...
Yan yung bedpan mo.
Ah, ito pala yung bedpan. Sorry lang. You need to put the bedpan, the pouch to your bedpan. Yung rationale dito is para hindi mag-leak your... Para hindi ba prevent leakage sa pasyente or para hindi ma-dislodge siya.
Oh, Jeff. Huwag ka mag-alala. Kalma. Makinig ka nalala.
Tapos, when you are removing the ano, kailangan mo siyang, kung kailangan niya ng ano, kailangan natin ng
ano. Ano bang kailangan ko? Kanyang nakapangalaman
ko
kailangan.
Kunyari,
may lagayan ako na iba na table.
Lagyan mo
sa bed ng ibang
patient.
Kunyari daw, sir. Yellow.
Sa baba.
Pati yung bed pan, sir?
Oo. Oh. Ilinisan mo yung mamaya, di ba, sa CR? Pasok mo. Tapos isarado mo, Christy.
Ah, okay. Tapos, tapos tunig ko ulit.
Ah, oh, sige. Nagabiti pa niya ulit. Oh, imagine, tinapo na, isarado mo yun.
Yung bed pan.
Amoy tayo na yun.
Tapos, kailangan ko.
Sa ilalim. Baka ma... Pag ganyan, bakit ang baho? Paglabas mo, nakita mo yung footstep na
lang. Hindi, kasi yung bedpan daw, may cover doon.
Ah, oh, walang cover ato yung bedpan.
So, yung cover, yung bedpan.
Yan yung cover mo. I-plastic mo lang.
Plastic ko, tapos, tripo pa ko ng gloves. Kasi tae yung hinawakan ko.
Ang baho?
Baho ko niya. Tapos,
sanitize ko
muna. Ay, sanitize ulit ako. Tapos, gloves ulit. Kasi, maglilinis ako ng stoma ulit.
Si patients, how do you position the patients? Lying down, sitting position?
No, sir. Ano? Nasa supine position siya.
But if, for example, I'm a normal person, yung, like, I take a bath, so, nakatayo lang ako. Kaya ko naman eh, pag mag-shower ako, I can always take care of myself.
Pwede ka rin umupo.
Pwede ka rin umupo.
Because I,
You what?
Ha?
Huh?
Pero
what?
Kung maglilinis ka naka-off, sir, parang...
Ang hirap.
Ang mahirap.
No, I'm talking about myself ba?
Akong ikaw lang.
Na-experience ko kasi yan. Pero lang. Ito lang siya. Opo, ganyan yung ano.
Hindi, pag-inquin.
Kasi operado to siya.
Oo, pwede. Okay.
Tapos,
pero,
kailangan
daw
na mga... Patay na, kasi nga pumutok nga. Nagnanasa na infection.
Ay, hindi na alagaan.
Hindi.
Tapos yung paper towels 80, is para malinis natin yung excess na tae sa...
What's the English of tae?
Feces.
Feces, ano pa?
Stool.
Stool, poop, ano pa? Kaka. Kaka, waste, yeah, okay.
Tapos, parang ipapadry lang natin kasi didikit naman siya actually yung po ganito sa, ano natin, sa stoma. Tapos,
hindi niya naman kanina.
Tapon ulit sa garbage sa, ano natin. Tapos, tanggal ulit tayo ng gloves.
Ay, grabe.
Marami tayong gloves na mauubos. Tapos,
madami na tayong oras na mauubos sa pagpapalit mo ng gloves.
Sige na sir, wag na ako mag-gloves.
Isang gloves na.
Ah, sige, sige. Tapos, ano, yung para maglinis tayo is hindi alcohol or what. Yung parang warm water lang yung gagamitin natin.
Bakit hindi alcohol?
Bahap din sir.
Good question. Bakit hindi sabon?
Kasi siya ay...
Bakit hindi sabon? Kasi nga,
kasi matapang yung sabon.
Ano daw, parang hindi ma-irritate yung...
And then remember, if you're doing it in the hospital, everything should be ordered by the doc, right? So, hindi ka pwede maglagay ako dyan ng ano, safeguard.
Yeah, at saka parang ma-irritate din daw yung ano. So, yung parang, ano lang, is safe lang is yung warm water. Tapos, madali siyang makapaglinis tayo ng...
Yeah. Alcohol can actually make it dry. So, if it dry, di ba, dapat it should be pink, red,
hindi ko
na
panood.
Hindi pa napapanood. And then also the sabon are also very harsh na mga chemicals or ingredients. So it's also not good. Water is enough.
Yeah,
warm
water. Kung sa Bisaya,
okay. Ito ano na to.
Ulitin mo yung pagpo-fold.
Parang bayabas good.
Yung ano, yung ito parang ano na to, nakasukna siya sa warm water. Tapos maglilinis.
Okay, pakita mo sa camera para manilagay.
Oh, para manilagay.
The mittens is how you're going to fold or use your towel sa pagbe-bed bath. So yun ang magbe-bed bath dito. This is how you're gonna do mittens.
Ayun o. Ang galing.
Dito lang. Tapos ganito natin. From dito. Sa gilid mo lang skin. Tapos dito. From dito lang. Sa dito. Sa baba. Tapos dito. Tapos.
Again, dun sa kanila. Sila yung stomach.
Dito. Like from... Tapos, di ba nagamit na natin to? Tapos dito.
Sa back naman.
Tapos, this, ano na natin, dun sa basin na may water, balik na ulit natin. Tapos, may dry towel tayo para i-dry natin yung skin. Para hindi siya mag-rush. Tapos, dun na natin i-check yung stoma natin if may problem, like, kung dark siya or may pus
so,
or bleeding.
So, can you
bleeding?
Open the, ano, her, describe mo nga kung paano yung mga unhealthy or sick na stoma. Sige nga, kayo nga. What can you see sa unhealthy or sick na stoma?
May
rashes.
Yes, may rash. What else?
May sobrang reddish.
Sobrang siya red, or maybe iba yung color, like bluish or dark. May pus or may nana. Ano pa?
Some of them, they have bleed also.
Bleeding.
May blood. Dapat there should be no blood, right? And there should be no pain. But I guess, by the looks of this, parang ang painful, no?
Kaya nga. Namamaga. Swelling siya, sir.
Kung nasa loob na yung stoma, it's abnormal already. So you need to...
Yung matanda na yung patient. Like my lola, age of 88 years old.
Opo.
Kaya nagkanana po siya.
Okay, so now you know the difference, no? Okay.
So, after assessing the patient, so kung normal naman, walang ganun. So we need to put na the new ostomy pouch. So, you need to put paste dito sa wafer para dumikit dito yung
yun ang
dati. Ano klaseng paste ba yan? Elmer's glue?
Glue stick?
Glue guy?
Basta may ostomy paste yata ako nalagay
doon. The picture?
May picture ba?
Wala.
Wala. Wala.
Basta hindi siya yung paste na paste. May paste na siya pang Osta.
Oo, pang Osta may paste. Tapos may skin paste optional. Yung adhesive remover lang din siya para dito. Tapos mayroon din siyang deodorant para hindi siya mag to prevent ano yung parang hindi mamamoy masyado. So before putting there, para ano, maglalagay, mag-i-spray tayo ng deodorant spray dito. Tapos, or before you put the ano, kailangan mo muna pala ito, i-measure yung stoma mo kung gano'n siya kalaki, tapos ikakat mo siya dito.
Ah, yun. Ang gusto ko itanong kanina. Oo.
Kasi may laki
sizes.
May sizes. Kasi ito parang ewan ko anong size na ito. So, maano mo naman kung gano'ng kalaki.
Ma-identify.
Actually guys, ang cute talaga ng Ostomy, meron ka parang kulmahal na may malaking bilog, may maliit na bilog, may ganyan-ganyan. Tapos, according to experience, or siguro if you not the experience, then you have to parang fit dito. Okay, ito bang bilog? This one. Ah, okay, this one. This small is ano? Ano yung mga sizes dyan?
May sizes dito.
Small, large, saka double
X. May 2 inches.
ED1.
2 inches, 1.5.
Ayun. So, makita mo na, okay, then you have to cut it using ano.
May scissor ako pala, nandun kay sir. So, yung scissor ko ganito.
So, what is your, for example, you just cut by estimate, no? So, which one is the best? Yung malaki na yung butas or maliit na butas?
Maliit. Na? Maliit para ma-adjust, siguro.
So, kung kunwari, hindi ako sure, siguro mga 2 inches to. So, ikakat mo ng or hindi, mga 3 inches siguro yan. So, ikikat mo ng 3 inches na gano'n. Pagtapos pa ganun palaki, 1.5 lag pala, lumaki masyado yung butas mo. So, paano mo yung papaliitin?
Wala na. No.
Wala na.
I-tape mo na lang. So, wala na. How much is this?
500 pesos.
To charge yun?
Sa patient. Patient.
Sa patient, diba? It's unfair for the patient. What if, hindi, dalawang, isang ostomy, may bagay na charge siya, bakit dalawa charge mo? Ay.
Mali.
Push up na. So, you better start small circle.
Yes,
tapos, sir. Pagdating mo dito, pag medyo ano pa siya, masikip pa, then, doon ka na maglaki pa ng konti, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, kunwari, ito yung stoma mo, tapos, ang laki na nga na buta, yung tae, nagkalap na ito, what if naman yung stoma mo, ito lang, pero sobrang liit naman.
Adjust na, no?
Adjust konti. So, dapat mo, ito, okay na ba yan?
Yes, okay na yan.
Okay na ba yan?
Ganyan pala ka siya, sir.
Ito, okay na ba yan?
Before you put ito daw na ostomy pouch, you need to check first the skin pala of the patient kung dapat wrinkle free siya para hindi siya mag-create ng MASD.
MASD.
Mask. Yung parang magmumoy.
Bed sores.
Yes. Parang ganun. Yung parang kasi diba magkakaroon siya ng face dito, so magkaka-rashes or whatsoever, so parang baka magkaroon ng gano'n. So, kailangan natin gano'n, ilagay. Tapos,
mask is moisture-associated skin damage.
Okay.
M-A-S-D. Damage.
Kasi di ba magkakaroon siya ng moist dito dahil nandun sa face niya. So, kailangan
number 23.
Kailangan natin wala siya noon. Mag-check natin before putting this one. So, wala yon. So, we need to put this one from the bottom to the top. So, we need to wait for around like 1 to 2 minutes para mag-check natin yung ostomy pouch natin is correct.
Question. Di ba this one is the ostomy pouch, right? So, should it be placed like this?
Yeah.
Or like this sa pagilid or pa ganito?
Pababa.
Pagilid?
Pababa.
Pababa.
Yan.
Yes, sir. It's supposed to be to pababa, pero it depends on the patient. You can ask the patient also if what as comfortable niya na side.
But definitely, hindi pwedeng pataas, right? So, magsistock lang dito. So, if the patient naman is lying down all day long, then okay lang siguro pababa. But if the patient is able to move or yung nag-walk yung patients every time, then dapat pababa na lang siya by gravity. Okay? So, let's follow na lang the pababa. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Tapos ganito. Then we have the clip also. You need to clip this one. Then you need to make sure that the ostomy pouch is ano, yung parang secure. You need to make like this.
So i-stretch mo konti para
secure or para alam mo na siya hindi na siya mahuhulog or what. Tapos kung may belt na siya, you need to put the belt kasi yung purpose ng belt is para siya protection siya, di ba? Pag like tumatayo siya or walking siya para hindi masyadong mabigat. So that's it. Tapos na tayo dun. Tapos after that, we will remove na yung ating...
So then you do that after?
Care. Tapos we will remove this one, the disposable, ano na to. Then remove the butt blanket also, then put the blanket of the patient, then bed rails up.
Nice.
Okay, so and then the rest is here. Any questions? Yeah.